Team Richard. Brutal Doom? What's Brutal Doom?
It's a Doom mod that makes it more brutal.
It's already pretty brutal and violent and stuff.
They've made it more violent and stuff.
I guess mostly my objection to Doom, to the extent that I have any, is that the graphics are just so ugly these days. I just can't handle pixelation anymore.
Oh, it's wonderful sprite art, and you're all nuts. It's beautiful Doom nostalgia. Greatness, wonderful joy.
See, I can enjoy...
Happy joy,
I can
Doom
enjoy
joy.
Pixelated Mario, but Doom, it's almost like I'd rather play Quake. Quake looks decent.
Oh.
And what was the other one I used to play? It wasn't Doom. It was another one that was similar like that. I can't even think of what it was called now.
I don't know.
Ooh, pretty. Psychedelic Pac-Man.
Yeah, the championship edition is weird.
Can you make it stop doing that?
Do what?
Shimmery, blurry, psychedelic.
Well, I think there's other styles I can.
Epileptic unfriendly. Not that I'm epileptic, fortunately.
I think that's an option.
But I think if you are epileptic, you probably wouldn't want to play this version of Pac-Man.
I prefer the original.
I'm guessing. I don't know.
The original championship, but I don't have a good version of that.
Is it weird hearing Rich speak fondly about nostalgia? Has Rich ever spoken unfondly about nostalgia?
Yeah.
Myself, I'm quite fond of the old NES games. Partly because they don't make me motion sick, and partly because I remember playing them as a wee Karen. Nostalgia is pretty much the only reason old games are good today. Well, some games I think are pretty timeless. I mean, I could be wrong, but I'm thinking that, you know, even little kids, a lot of people would probably enjoy really well-written games like the original Super Mario Brothers.
Well-made games?
Yeah, well-made games, whereas...
Mario wasn't known for his elaborate plot twists.
Yeah, yeah. See, I can
then,
play...
the princess was in another castle!
On another castle. I remember, you know, I mean, I enjoy Mario. On the other hand, maybe it was because I never had one, but I really can't get into most of the Atari games. And a lot of the old, super old arcade games. Although, you know, Pac-Man is fun. Pac-Man has always been fun.
This is such a weird version of Pac-Man.
It is a very weird and psychedelic version.
It's conga line Pac-Man.
Yeah. I think my favorite Pac-Man game is still probably... I like that one, the Pac-Man Versus.
Oh, yeah. Versus is fun. We should do that at some point.
We should. Except that you're so darn good at it.
Yeah.
Pac-Man Versus... let's see. Pac-Man... one person's Pac-Man, and they're playing it on the Game Boy, and they can see the whole... screen or part of the screen.
Yep. And everyone else is playing on the GameCube.
Yeah, and then the ghosts are... Everybody else is the ghosts on the GameCube. And I think they see the whole screen. All of them are looking at their GameCube. It's been a while. We are living in a golden age of gaming.
Are we?
I don't know. There are advantages and disadvantages to every era.
Ooh, this sounds deep. Please explain.
Well, you know, I mean, you didn't have to worry about, you didn't have as much, I mean, there was a time when the idea that I would have a cell phone and be able to emulate any Nintendo game on frickin' Earth if I wanted to would have been absolutely mind-blowing when I was a kid. On the other hand, I didn't have to worry about, what do you call it when I can't, I'm blanking out, what do you... The microtransactions.
Oh, yep.
I didn't have to worry about microtransactions in, you know, 1990, 1989, 1985. Gotta be honest, at work we have a giant board game with all the games we could release because of Pixels.
Hmm?
Oh, Pixels? Like Pixels the game?
The movie?
I don't know. Yeah, that's what I meant.
What do they say? What was the whole comment?
About how great the graphics are. I think I missed the beginning of this.
It's okay.
Rich, which is better, XTRO or SOS?
SOS. I'm not as fond as of Extro as everyone else was. It's a good movie. But I'm not particularly a horror guy, and it's not funny bad, so it's not... Shit! There's not as much in Extro for me.
You know, I think when you talk about, like, the gold... What's the golden age of gaming, or what's the golden age of music, there's always good stuff, and there's always shit in any era. Sometimes what's getting, you know, marketed more in your face in commercials is more the shit. But there's always something good. And there's always stuff that's crap. Whether you're talking about books or movies or music or games. And yeah, because there's more sheer volume of games now, there's more shit than there used to be. There's also more good stuff, potentially. The golden age games is the 90s. I think, you know, people will probably go and say whenever they grow up is the golden age of everything. Yeah. It's just, you know, when things are new and you're a young kid, you just whatever was popular when you were, say, age 12 to age 22, give or take, you're going to think was the best time for the best everything, which is why the baby boomers think that everything from their era was the best ever, not because it necessarily was. Some of it was great and some of it was shit. But because that's when they were that age. There were no shitty movies in the 15th century. This is true, but there were probably shitty plays. Fortunately, you know, the really shitty ones don't tend to be remembered. You know, we've got Shakespeare, you know, and probably, you know, Joe Smith's shitty plays. Nobody remembers, like, they remember Shakespeare's. Well, somebody's commenting there were no shitty movies in the 15th century. Yeah, there were no movies.
Does this look better?
It's still got weird moving effects in the screen. It's pretty. It seems like it would be kind of disorienting to play. Well, not like a head pain necessarily. Maybe eye strain. That's better. It's better when I don't really care too much about the periphery, but when the actual parts that Pac-Man's zipping around in. They're doing weird, freaky things. Other than just changing their levels of illumination. It's a bit disorienting. Somebody said, I wonder if there are people who enjoyed shitty plays back in the 15th century the way we enjoy shitty movies. Oh, probably. And people who enjoyed them for their sheer shittiness, like the producers. You know, that's the whole premise of that movie.
That's what they're talking about, yeah.
Yeah. Springtime for Hitler in Germany. Germany. 1984 was the best of cinema. 1984 was certainly a good year for cinema. Gremlins, Indiana Jones, Ghostbusters, Beverly Hills.
80s was the best for cinema.
Now, do you think that's because there was less CGI, or because budgets were smaller, or the demand for return on investment was less?
Not that CGI is inherently bad. Those terrible CGI is less preferable to shitty practical effects.
Is the problem with obsession with box office numbers and ROI?
I think the problem is without CGI, you had to have a better story. You had to have better storytelling. You had to know what you were doing to make a fun movie.
See, I'm always loath to say that any given era was better than another, especially if it happens to be when I was a kid, simply because, you know, everything's better when you're 10.
Mm-hmm. No, I think when you couldn't do everything you wanted, you had to be smart about what you did.
Okay. I mean, I agree, 1984 had some great movies. And while I'm old enough to remember 1984, my memory doesn't go back too much before that. As far as actually seeing things when they came out. Okay, well, somebody's suggesting that they've become too corporatized, and I guess that decisions are made too much by committee.
Yeah.
There's not enough creative control for directors or writers or whatever. Killing Fields in 1984. Was Return of the Jedi 1984?
It was 3.
83.
Why is that your... When cinema went bad to you?
No, what is... no. Somebody was saying that 1984 was a really good year for movies, and the other people were naming other movies that came out in 1984, and I was thinking, did that come out in 1984 as well? And I couldn't remember.
Ghostbusters 84.
Yeah, they mentioned that. What year did Blues Brothers come out? 81?
81 or 2.
So is that a movie about the decline of the American Mall?
Raiders of the Lost Ark. Was Raiders of the Lost Ark 81 or 80?
Oh.
I think it was 81, but I could be wrong.
That's a good movie. See, they did special effects in that movie, but they did them with waxworks.
Yeah. Well, a whole bunch of different things. Miniatures and whatnot.
Yeah. But, like, I mean, these days they would have made the Nazis being melted by the Ark CGI. And then they did them by fashioning them from wax and melting them. Oh, Taxi Driver. Yeah, 1976 Taxi Driver. Rocky, The Omen, Marathon Man, Bad News Bears. What year did The Exorcist come out?
I don't know.
Is that 76? It's in the 70s, I think.
Yeah, but I couldn't tell you when. I really couldn't.
Rich's mother and her brothers made a home movie version of... I don't know if it still exists, but I've seen it.
I don't know what the hell happened to it.
Yeah, I believe his mother was Reagan. Or Regan, the girl. Your mother was the girl, right? Yeah. His mother and his siblings did a remake of The Exorcist that is just darling. This was before Rich was even born. 74 for The Exorcist. Yeah, that probably sounds about right. Rich's mother was just a young thing in that production. Quite charming. 73, yeah.
Mother loved, she loved horror movies.
Yeah, his mother was a huge fan of horror movies. We used to watch them together sometimes. Bad, the worst, the okay, while I generally don't like bad movies, I love bad, cheesy horror movies. Especially, like, old ones.
Uh-huh.
Rich's mother and I used to watch. See, Evil Dead, I like it well enough, but it's intentionally bad. There's something about, you know, while I generally don't like movies that are unintentionally horrible, I kind of make the exception for horror movies. Is this why Rich's sister is all messed up? Because his mother liked horror movies? No, I...
They're thinking about the Mormon one.
Oh! No. That's his sister on the other side of the family.
Yeah.
His Mormon sister wasn't even close to thinking about being born when his mother was making home movies of The Exorcist. Nor was she the mother of that sister. The first movie Rich and I saw together?
Oh, I couldn't even tell you.
What was the movie that we had our first kiss during?
After.
Well, yes.
I wouldn't say it was because of the movie either.
No. You want to tell him what movie it was?
Go ahead. Midnight Cowboy.
Hey, I'm walking here.
Everybody's talking about me.
Yeah, it's not exactly a romantic film, but... Yes, his sister's a Mormon. Rich has more than one sibling. Rich has a lot more than one sibling.
Yeah. I've got 3 sisters and 2 brothers.
Yeah.
I am the oldest of them all.
Kung Fu Panda.
Haven't seen it.
Kung Fu Panda wasn't out when Rich and I became a couple.
You're gonna date us.
Yeah. Well, Kung Fu Panda has only been out for, what, like 4 years or something?
Aren't
they on 3
probably
now?
A little bit, yeah, but I don't think there's been one every year.
I don't know.
God damn it.
I think I saw one of them. I don't, you know.
I haven't seen any.
They're kid flicks. And they're not necessarily even.
There's something my Mormon sister would probably feel safe watching.
I think Kung Fu
Panda. That is if she could handle the Eastern culture aspect of it. I don't know.
Kung Fu Panda probably exists. She's a good kid.
I know.
But Kung Fu Panda, I think, mostly exists so that parents could take their kids to something that they're sure isn't going to be objectionable. Which is all well and good, but movies don't have to be objectionable to be enjoyable, but often a movie whose sole purpose is to be unobjectionable is.
God damn you, Pac-Man!
Unless it's Pixar. Kung Fu Panda is 7 years old, okay. They say you're the most interesting man in the world.
That's true.
Which world?
All of them.
All of them. Am I going to take the good Evans name once I get married? I intend to. Karen Evans works. I mean, if his last name was like Smugalagovitz, it would be a harder choice.
So you would say no if it was Smugalagovitz?
If it was Smugalagovitz, I'd convince you to take my name.
Are you racist against Smugalagovitz?
How could you be racist against what you are? White. Smugalagovitz sounds like a good Polish name or something. I don't know. Fortunately, we both have easy to pronounce and easy to read names. Smugalagovitz is a fine Scottish name. Rich Smugalovich. Anti-Semite? I'm not an anti-Semite. I'm not anti-anything. Karen Smugalagovitz sounds pretty good, too.
Yeah, you'd be the only Smugalagovitz anyone knows.
I had a...
Other than your husband, who would by necessity also be a Smugalagovitz.
I knew somebody whose name was Sue, and she married somebody whose last name was Galooly. So she turned into Sugalooly.
Ooh.
And Sugalooly is a little... is right up there with names that rhyme. Or names that are repetitive, like Robbie Robertson. You know, and there are people who do that to their kids. But
Spider-Man character, Robbie Robertson?
Yeah. You know. Well, Robertson. There's a Robert and Robert kind of thing. First name, last name, and the guy from the band.
It's better than Anakin.
Anakin Skywalker?
Somebody named their kid Anakin.
Well, if it wasn't for that movie, Anakin wouldn't be a bad sounding name, I suppose.
You name your kid after a character who was basically a child murderer.
I know somebody whose kid's middle name is Jedi.
Yeah, I know. That was a fine idea there.
He seems happy enough.
What if he hates Star Wars?
I have no idea. I've never asked him.
How old is Jedi now?
Oh my goodness, well... I think last time I saw him in person was probably about 4 years ago, and I think he's probably about 6 or 7. He's got to be pushing double digits. I think his sister's in high school. You know someone named Annika? Is that Japanese or something? Or is it named after Annika? I guess it's been out long. Well, I guess it didn't have to be that long at all. Out that long.
Annika
at all.
Works better than Anakin.
I don't think you really know anyone who named their kid Pantera Rules. I certainly hope not.
Pantera Rules?
Yeah.
I think I can see it.
I don't think you can smoke enough dope to think that's a good idea.
Oh my god. This is
Mustard
crazy.
Evans? I don't think Rich would want to name his kid Mustard Evans. He's not very fond of mustard.
They know that.
I like mustard.
You like mustards?
Mustard.
Mustards.
Oh, shut up. I like all kinds of things that Rich doesn't like.
Oh, shit! Oh, shit!
Like
oh, shit! Oh, shit!
After I eat them.
Oh, wow. I almost fucked that up. Get you ghost, you... Oh my god!
Your friends did name their child Anakin? Hey. Whatever you're into. Yes, Rich is fucking stupid good at this game. I agree with you. He's, like, ridiculously good at Pac-Man. He should be on, like, King of Kong. Hey, why is King of Kong, they're playing Pac-Man, right?
Yeah.
So why didn't they call it, like, King of Pac?
You know why it wouldn't be? No, they play Donkey Kong and King of Kong.
Oh, is it? Okay.
I wouldn't be any good at that kind of Pac-Man, because the way they beat that is they have, like, a pattern that you have to do. It's very much they found a way around the AI rather than they're playing the game. So I would probably be bad at like, seeing the final screen at Pac-Man, but something like this.
The conga line ghosts are just strange.
Yeah. I prefer the normal championship edition, but any port in a storm, I don't know.
I don't know, everything looks good on this television.
Just as far as gameplay goes. I prefer it when the ghosts chase you more than I like the conga line stuff. Oh god, oh god.
I mean, I'm used to playing stuff on, like, my little laptop screen. I'm not used to playing anything on a regular TV anymore. Much less one with a nice picture. Rich, do you like Great Poupon? See, that's the thing.
Tell him the story.
Yeah, like, Rich doesn't like mustard. And so he's like, oh, I don't like mustard. And I'm thinking, you know, yellow mustard isn't real mustard. I mean, it's real mustard, but it sucks. You know, it's like the mustard of last resort. It's the mustard of saving money for your store by getting cheap mustard and giving it to people. You know, yellow mustard is just vinegar in mustard. So I'm like, well, Rich, you know, we'll give you some real mustard, and maybe you like mustard now. So I gave him some nice, good German brown mustard. Good stuff. And he really hated it. He really, really hated it.
How long was I gagging?
Yeah, I mean, he looked like he was just had turds in his mouth or something. So he does not like mustard. He also doesn't like herring. He likes, you know, kind of like bland, boring American food. Preferably deep fried, and I like the weird shit. I like the roll mops and the canned herring and the mustard. And
also not that big on sweets.
Yeah, he doesn't have much of a sweet tooth, but he likes fatty foods.
Yeah.
So he's not crazy about cake, but cheese fries, yes. You're allergic to horseradish? Yellow is the only one you know. Wasabi? Do you like wasabi, Rich? I'm guessing not.
I don't even know what wasabi is. I've never tasted wasabi.
It's basically horseradish. Okay. I mean, real Japanese wasabi isn't horseradish quite, but I never even had. And in the United States, it's like horseradish dyed green. Pickled herring is great, isn't it? Wrapped around pickles? It's delicious. I'd be right at home in Iceland. I probably would, but don't they do that, like, salty... There was a girl from Finland who was an exchange student at my high school, and she did black licorice with salt. And I was like, ugh.
Who was it?
This girl from Finland.
I don't remember her.
So, I mean, do the Iceland people do Finland with salt? Because, I mean, not Finland, licorice with salt, because I can't do licorice with salt. But yeah, I think I probably would like the food in Iceland. Iceland seems like a perfectly lovely place. Would Rich starve to death in Japan?
Yes.
Well,
it's nothing but seafood, right?
It's nothing but seafood now.
And rice.
Well, and rice.
I'd have rice.
You'd have rice, he says. They own Kobe beef. They're known for that.
Yeah.
Grass-fed Kobe beef, you know. Cheeseburger. Karen, Rich, do you like wasabi? Rich, cheeseburger?
Yeah, oh, cheeseburger, yes. Yeah. Pizza? Oh, pizza.
He does not hate mustard. Mustard hates him. No, he hates mustard. Mustard might or might not hate him, but... When Steve Gibson first became casually involved with the online community of mustard makers, he had no idea his mild interest in the condiment world would, within a few short months, spiral dangerously out of control. You know, Rich, I doubt, has ever had lutefisk. I've never had lutefisk. Lutefisk and the gel filte, or whatever it is, the I don't know, it's like Yiddish cuisine or something. Those are things that are...
Gefiltefish?
Gefilte, whatever it is, fish.
I think it's gefilte fish.
Yeah, I've never had that either.
Oh god, it's too fast! It's too fast!
I would love to, you know. I like to smoke herring and smoke salmon and whatnot on bagels and stuff like that. I mean, there's a lot of good like Yiddish cuisine that I've had, but I've never had the fish and I've never had the lutefisk. Lutefisk sounds sort of gross, but Might be good. And fermented dishes? Yeah, I mean, I like sauerkraut and I like yogurt. I've also never had kimchi or thousand-year-old eggs. I mean, they're all on the list of things that I would be willing to try. Lord Belmont hates mayonnaise. Mayonnaise is okay.
You would try pretty much anything.
I would try pretty
much
anything.
You're an adventurous eater.
I'm an adventurous eater, yeah. Well, you know, I might hate Lutefisk, but I'd like to just try it just to check it off the list.
If I died once tonight?
I don't think so. But I wasn't looking at the screen continuously either.
Having a decent Pac-Man night.
It's the jerky of the sea. Kimchi is like Asian sauerkraut. Well, I do like, I do like sauerkraut. Worcestershire sauce? That's okay. As an ethnically Jewish person, Tiberius hates Jill Filta fish. Like I said, I'd like to try it. I've heard very mixed things about it. There are foods I like, and there are foods I like less, and there are foods that I'm not especially fond of. There aren't too many things where it's like, ew, yuck, get this out of my mouth. You know, I generally will eat pretty much anything. I take after my father. He's a pretty adventurous eater, whereas my mother is, like, rich. You know, just kind of wants to eat the relatively bland,
the good stuff.
You know, straightforward meat, mostly meat, potatoes, and bread kind of deal. Does Rich like steak? Of course Rich likes steak. Other than vegetarians, you know, of course, like Hindus.
Slap that cow in my mouth.
A religious objection. Most people like steak. Pickles with milk? That doesn't sound very good. Actually, I think one of the grosser things that I've eaten, and it was kind of on a dare, we were playing like Truth or Dare as kids, they took a chocolate cupcake, hollowed it out, and filled it up with ketchup. And do not like that. Marmite is also on the list of things I'd like to try. I have actually never tried Marmite. Rich, do you like mushrooms and onions? Wait, yeah, wait. You do, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Your mushrooms are wonderful. Woo! Especially mushrooms with butter and garlic. You know, or a big portobello sandwich. Does Rich like tacos? Who doesn't like tacos? Tacos are just like tortilla shells. And you can fill them with all kinds of shit. You don't like your steak cooked further than rare. I like it medium rare. I like a little bit of that browned taste, but definitely if you overcook your steak, it's ruining it.
I had more just stuff unlocked. Maybe I had to reinstall for some reason. I don't know.
Well, I try a single plum floating in perfume served in a man's hat.
What's that
a reference?
What's that? Yes, I can't remember what it's from, though.
Anytime I've accidentally gotten perfume in my mouth, I haven't enjoyed it. And yes, Rich does not like Grey Poupon. Pulled pork? I'm guessing that's probably a sex joke, but if it isn't, pulled pork sandwiches are wonderful. We were at Culver's the other day. They have like these pulled pot roast sandwiches, which are really quite good. And they've got their sweet potato fries, although these were overdone. What are you going to do?
Nothing.
Tacos can be fine anywhere.
Absolutely nothing.
Fish tacos are good. Shrimp tacos are good.
I don't think you should be saying fish tacos are good.
Oh, that sounds wrong, doesn't it? Tacos made with animals caught in the sea. General Zukov says they think Jack believes a hot dog is not a sandwich. Well, it's on a bun, and it's not a regular sandwich thing. Of course, sandwiches can be open-faced. So really, I suppose it depends on, you know, what you consider a sandwich.
Look, Jack has all kinds of crazy beliefs.
In Canada, you have pulled pork poutine. Isn't that... I thought that
poutine
had to be, like,
good.
French fries. I've never had it. It's like French fries
and
cheese
gravy.
And gravy, right? I'm not usually a big fan of gravy, but gravy is a broad term. Or, you know, you can have white-colored gravies and brown-colored gravies, and you can make gravy a lot of ways, so. Poutine is on my list of things to try, but I've actually never had it. Rich, got any stories about when you ate that fucking mound of cheeseburgers during early 2014 Wolf of Wall Street?
It was for one of the reviews. Mr. Plinkett ate a bunch of cheeseburgers. Not really. It's not like I literally ate them all. I mean, there's some movie magic going on. Eat a little bit. They filmed some of it, and they were all fresh burgers, and I didn't eat the ones that I shoved a ton of butter on. You know, that was just on the ones I didn't eat. They're just normal Burger King double cheeseburgers.
Well, doesn't Culver's do like butter burgers where they like put butter on the bun
and toast
it?
I think so, but I just for the bit in the show, I was putting on like an obscene amount of butter.
Oh, okay. It wasn't just like put a little butter on.
Yeah. No, Plinkett was trying
to roll the bread and
sushi? Plinkett was trying to induce a heart attack because his insurance was getting ready to run out.
Do I like sushi? I do like sushi.
Oh, fuck!
I like
God
sashimi,
damn it.
Too, and I recognize that there's a difference. Sushi is not necessarily... Sushi usually... The rice is what makes it sushi. It's not raw fish. Although you could put raw fish in sushi. Yeah, I like sushi. Sushi's good. Sushi's a rather broad thing. You know, it's kind of like saying, do you like sandwiches? Sushi can be made a lot of ways. But yeah, I've had lots of sushi that I like. Yeah, I agree with you, JG Glag 35, whatever. Sushi isn't always raw fish. In fact, sushi isn't usually raw fish. It's the sticky rice wrapped around thing that makes it sushi, and I'm not sure if the nori is a defining ingredient. Uni sea urchin searching sushi, never had that. I like eel sushi a lot. Do I like haggis? I've never had haggis.
Would you try haggis?
I would try most things unless they involve, you know, bodily waste. And I don't know that I would want to try mountain oysters. And although I realize they're perfectly legitimate foods and millions of people all over the world, if not billions, enjoy them, I'm not big on bugs. Although I realize that shrimp isn't too far removed. And by the way, if you're ever in Milwaukee, go to El Fuego and get the coconut shrimp. Oh my god, it is so good.
What is El Fuego?
El Fuego is a restaurant in Milwaukee on something street.
Layton.
I don't Layton know if there's
Avenue.
More than one. On what? Clayton?
Layton.
On Layton Avenue, and they have one of their lunch specials. It's shrimp breaded in coconut flakes. And then, or, you know, shredded coconut or whatever, and then deep fried. And then they give you a cup of, I think it's probably coconut milk and coconut flakes and pineapple mixed together. And you dip it in there, and it's, you know, it's indulgent, and it's probably going to give me a heart attack. You know, and then they serve it, obviously, with a side of refried beans and rice. But it's good.
So if I can do that without dying.
When you go to Milwaukee, it'll be cheese, beer, and beer. Well, you know. Cheese you can get a lot of places. But, you know, beer...
What's wrong with that?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And beer, yeah. Milwaukee's got good beer. There's all kinds of beer here. But I like Lakefront Brewery, one of the little brewery tour. They had some good stuff.
I wouldn't say I noticed cheese being any better in Milwaukee than it is in Chicago.
Yeah. But... you know, if you're in Milwaukee and you get tired of beer and cheese, I would definitely recommend El Fuego. They've got good food. Rich, are you the White Sox? Are White Sox the only sports team you follow?
Those are the teams I like. But as far as hardcore follow, I mean, I'm in general, I think I'm a fairly fair-weathered fan. Teams.
Yeah, I mean,
I'll be honest about that.
When the White Sox have a year like they had this year, at some point you just
yeah.
Stop
when they're
watching.
Doing terrible,
it's
I just don't want to see it.
Yeah.
Yes, it's depressing.
But yeah, we're Sox fans, and you know, generally if you're outside of the Chicago area, I make a point of wearing a White Sox hat because everybody wants to tell me how much the Cubs suck,
and you
just I don't
have to
really
say
care.
Yeah, I
yeah,
know.
I don't really care.
I agree.
Both my parents are Cubs fans, oddly enough, but. You know, Rich and I are both from the south end of
my little
suburbia
rebel.
And Pardon?
Your My little rebel.
Well, they're both from the South Side, but they raised all their kids in the South Suburbs, and all their kids are Sox fans. So go figure. Do they eat pizza with a fork in Milwaukee? Does anybody outside of Europe do strange things like that?
California might.
Okay.
Pineapple. Oh, God.
All right, I'll make an exception. I don't know if they have it up here, but there's a pizza place called Giordano's in Chicago. If I'm eating a deep dish pizza pie that's 2 inches thick, use a fork for that because it's got sauce on top and you'll just have sauce everywhere if you eat that with your fingers because it kind of falls apart. But in like regular, normal, thin crust, Chicago-style pizza, quote-unquote Chicago-style, yeah, no fork. Unless there's, you know, people around me are doing it and for some reason I want to impress them. But in general, you know, you just pick it up. Ham and pineapple, not ham.
Shit, spot I died last time.
Giordano's isn't pizza, it's a lasagna. Yeah, it's basically a lasagna without noodles. And that's okay.
Oh,
also,
fuck you, Piggy!
Also, lasagna often has meat. Base bait is sick of pizza. How can you get sick of pizza? You eat fries with a fork? I know a lot of European types. When I was in Germany, at McDonald's, they had these little tiny itty-bitty two-tined wooden forks for the French fries, which, you know, okay. But that's definitely not how I'm used to eating them. Rich, do you like donairs?
What's a donair?
What's a donair? Is that a donut or a pizza place?
It's like something I do with my liver, like a sick child. Kidney.
Seattle has terrible Italian food. Does Seattle have much of an Italian-American community?
Now, for a difference of...
I think that they would be like fish or like Asian food or something.
For a difference of 100 miles, I can't find a great Euro place up here.
Yeah, does anybody know of a really top-notch Euro place
everyone,
in the Milwaukee
Everyone
area?
Wants to say Oakland Euros, and they're bleh. They're blah.
No, you mostly like Mickey's down there, right?
Yeah, Mickey's is good. Mickey's is great.
Am I ever going to be on Best of the Worst? I don't know.
Nope.
No promises.
She would hate it. Because she would hate it. She's not a bad movie person.
Unless it's like a really bad horror movie. Although I enjoyed watching that one movie last time I was up here with the Japanese vampires that were hopping around. And the weird drug dealers or whatever they were. Euro in the Midwest, the fuck? It should be easy. Meat chopped up, spice, slapped on a spit. I guess, you know, probably you'd want to figure out where a lot of Greek neighborhoods are, maybe?
Maybe.
Good Euros. Where do Greek people in Milwaukee live? Is there an ethnic Greek neighborhood in this area? There's probably one somewhere.
I haven't had a Euro up here, though, that's made me go, holy fuck, that's good. I've had Euros up here that were like, that was an acceptable Euro. Yeah, but that's not the same thing.
And I'm not the fair person to ask. Am I planning on moving Milwaukee? Yes, but I don't know exactly when.
Oh, shit.
I don't like Euros. I like lamb, and I like goat.
You hate Euros.
You know, like barbecued lamb, barbecued goat. Those are good. Goat's got tends to have a lot of bones.
I'm going to do this fucking stage without dying. It's
goat cheese
happen.
Is good. You're living in Vegas right now? Vegas, I hear it's got nice weather. I'm not sure what else it has.
Gambling,
but yeah, but you can only, you know, unless you're rich, you can only gamble so much. It's like, gambling is something you do on vacation. It's not really a perk to move somewhere unless you want to work in the hospitality industry. Who said there was good Italian food in Seattle? There's probably some somewhere. I've never actually been to Seattle. Do I like duck? I've never tried duck. Wait, have I? Yeah, I have, actually. It's good. Yeah, lamb
this
is
just
wonderful.
In! Karen likes duck!
Yeah, lamb is wonderful. Lamb is wonderful. Lamb and goat are not that... Yeah, people do gamble themselves to death and into suicide and this, that, and the other. Some people...
I know, it's great!
Some people are addicted. But, no, Rich does not have a gambling problem. And I definitely don't have a gambling problem. I just look at it and say, you know what? I'm going to lose. statistically, yeah. So why bother? I mean, I would go there. I would go to Vegas for like the shows and stuff, and maybe play like nickel slots or something. But I'm just not a big gambler.
Do you remember Pogo.com?
Yeah, I remember Pogo.com.
You know how one of the games they had was poker?
Yeah.
And you know, it was completely free to play. You played with imaginary money.
Yeah.
Credits.
Right.
And I used to play in like the 100,000 credit room a lot, just for fun. And over time, I'd save myself up like 100,000 credits.
Okay.
And I thought I was getting pretty decent at playing poker on Pogo.com. So I figured,
this
fuck it.
This isn't going to end well.
Yeah, fuck it. I'll go into the 100,000 credit room. So I had just enough. I just managed to save up 100,000 credits. So I go in there and Pac-Man's happening. Doing pretty decently. And I had a hand came up. I had like two jacks, and the flop was jack, ace, ace. So I had a full house.
I don't even know how to play poker.
And I went, that's a really good hand.
Okay.
I went all in with three jacks and two aces.
And you lost?
And yeah, the other fucker had three aces and two jacks. So.
Aww. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's fine. It's fine. I lost. Basically, I lost it all. It was like months of playing the game, just you know, fairly casually, saving up 100,000 credits.
I'm sorry.
Oh, it's okay. It was a valuable lesson in gambling.
I had a coworker at work. We used to have a scratch off machine, and she was playing it a fair amount. And we were both working late, And she's like, Karen, you gotta play. So I'm like, all right, I'll play one. So I bought a $5 card, and I won $50, and I came out ahead, and I said, I'm done.
Mm-hmm.
I said statistically, I'm never gonna improve on this. I'm done. And I never played it again, because I thought, you know, statistically, I'm gonna give it back to them. This is good right here, you know? So I had my $45, and I had dinner with Rich, nice dinner with Rich, and, you know? I was good with that, and she wanted me to play more, and I'm like, no, I'm not. Statistically, I am gonna lose out here, you know. Statistically, this is probably the best it's gonna get. Rich, can you count cards?
No,
probably not. We're not Rain. Neither of us is Rain Man, nor are we like mathematical geniuses or.
You don't necessarily have to be Rain Man. There's a lot of people who get kicked out of
casinos. That's true.
For doing something that should be perfectly legal, really.
Yeah. Well, I'm either not clever enough or I just don't give enough of a shit, but I don't know how to do that. And
get in my belly!
I'm sure it could be lucrative, if that's your thing. You guys prefer Five Guys or In-N-Out? I've never been to
either. We don't have either around here.
we have Five Guys by me. I've
Since
never
when?
Actually been there.
Are they new? Or have they
There's
been...
one in New Orleans.
Since when?
I don't know. They've got everything in the whole world on the Grange Road now out there.
Oh, fuck
you guys.
Next time
you're by me, we'll take a field trip out there. They've built up so much stuff there, and they're still, the Grange is still under construction. Five Guys and In-N-Out. Yeah, I don't think we have In-N-Out in Milwaukee or in the greater Chicago area, south suburbs in particular.
That's a better score.
We like the Melrose over in Oak Creek as far as restaurants.
Oh. I was drawing a blank on the name.
Omega?
The Secret Agent place.
Oh, the...
Safe House. They're fun. I don't know, the food's killer.
There's a place in Milwaukee called the Safe House that's a Cold War era, like 1960s maybe, spy-themed restaurant. And they got a lot of cute, gimmicky stuff. And the a lot of the dishes are named after things. You know, it's kind of like a Get Smart Uncle. Yeah. It's a lot of fun.
What do you think of this?
It looks like Pac-Man in Legoland.
Mm-hmm. Is this acceptable to you?
It's fine. I don't know.
I know you weren't liking the look earlier.
Oh, I don't care. I'm not even looking at it that much. You can play whatever you want. You don't have to base it on whether or not
I'm playing different things because I want to play different things.
Okay. I like the rainbow ghosts. Is this Pac-Man being chased by his denied sexuality?
Yes.
They want him to come out of the rainbow ghosts want him to come out of the closet.
Hold on, fucking Blinky.
He's got Miss Pac-Man is his beard. Is Miss Pac-Man Pac-Man's beard?
No, I think she's his missus. I think the rumors are just that.
Okay. Am I getting sick or is it hot up there?
The heater's really good. I might just be getting hot. Oy vey.
If I get Jack's cold, I'm gonna be pissed off.
Fine.
I hate being sick, especially because it's gonna be busy at work.
Everyone around here is sick. Except for me.
You have super abilities.
Not typically, but I've been lucky.
Do you remember when you guys were filming Gorilla Interrupted?
You gave everyone
your typhoid-rich disease. You were a little bit sick. I got it, but I wasn't, like, all sleep-deprived like you guys, so it was like an ordinary cold for me. And
I was very sick.
Garrett was the funniest, because the night he came up there, he was, like, 20 at the time. The night he came up there, he was, like, bouncing up and down on your mattress like a 5-year-old, and just totally hyper and happy and excited.
Garrett was like a 5-year-old.
No, Garrett was.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. He was all excited. And that was ages ago. He was just a kid. And then it was like 2 days later, he got your cold, and he was like, I puked in your sink. Looked like he was ready to die. All of the bounce had gone out of him. I felt bad for the kid.
Oh, God.
Taco Bell is the best vegetarian option. Taco Bell is...
that's a funny joke.
Yeah, Taco Bell is like... They should just go vegetarian and try to pass themselves off as a health food option. I mean, like, I think they got sued because in order to call something beef, it had to be, like, 39%. Who the hell came up with that law in the first place? You think it would have to be, like, at least 50.1%, you know? More beef than not beef, but they couldn't even hit the 39%
lobbyist
target? Yeah. I mean, when the goal is 39% beef and you can't even manage that, they could call it, like, beef flavored or something, but clearly it's not beef at that point.
Oh, wow. It's getting too fast.
And yeah, they have a value menu, and I don't even think their taco filling tastes bad, but it's not really beef, and we know it. Taco Bell is the best dog food available in a chain restaurant. Have you seen dog food lately? I mean, like, quality dog food? My mom gets the dog these little, like, Tupperware containers full of, like, dog food that I haven't tried any, but it looks and smells like actual food. It's got, like, recognizable chunks of chicken and, like, peas and stuff in there. It's like little shelf-stable TV dinners for dogs. And I guess you're supposed to feed a whole one to
and
a small dog, but he's a large dog, so she just puts part of it on him.
He still stole your sandwich.
Yeah, he still stole my sandwich. The other day I closed my eye, or turned my back, I left the room for a minute, I come back, and my dog has eaten my whole sub. He's just running away from me with the jaws going real fast.
Oh, fuck, back, oh God! Doggy!
That's kind of what I said.
I survived! I fucking survived! Look at trapped in there!
Okay.
Fucking survived!
Stop screaming. Relax.
That was amazing!
Good.
That was amazing! That was was fucking great.
Wow. I didn't know somebody could have an orgasm from playing Pac-Man.
Fuck you.
I'm kidding.
Fuck you. That was the most amazing Pac-Man thing to have ever happened.
Were they able to see that?
Yes.
Okay. Well, somebody else said it was amazing. I didn't even see. I wasn't even looking at the screen. I just heard you screaming and looked over.
Oh.
Congratulations or something. Yeah, thank somebody you. Said that was sex, right? Where did my... Uh-oh. Where did my... Oh. Okay. You got a place to plug... I'm going to go use the restroom. Can
yeah,
you find...
Yeah, I think... You know, I think we're about, yeah. about done, my, actually.
Yeah, the Chromebook just croaked, so I don't have a convenient way to look at the chat.
Who's that? Fisted by Dope Smoke says... Thank you.
Well, you're welcome.
You're welcome, Fisted by Dope Smoke.
And a dollar from Woodchip says... I love you. We love you, too, in a purely platonic way.
We're going to read off some names, you and me. Can you see it easier here or on the little screen?
Probably on the little screen. That's okay. The big screen. I'm a bit nearsighted.
Let's have you read out some of these people.
Beermeister2089, thank you very much.
Well, you know what? There's so many. We'll just do the thanks at the end. We'll read the
47
names.
Viewers resubscribed while we are away, and we thank them, or we thank him or her, if that's one person. Mall Rat Call. Thank you. Tiberius Kirk. Dylan Lip. Wilkins the Clown.
Put some oomph into it.
Sloshed from DuckTales.
There you go.
Hero Yug. Elvis Delvis. Xenotrope. Shakespeare.
Shark. Sharkspear.
Unpowerful Raindrop. Billy Hecka.
I think it's just Bill La Hecka.
Bill La Hecka?
Yeah.
Mo Key B 85.
Now, Jack has corrected me on Bill La Hecka like a number of times, and I always get it wrong, so I'm not confident in myself.
Grakenek. Theodore J. Hooker. NSF Woofie.
Wookie.
Crocodile Brain.
You really gotta nail the last one. And
Crocodile Brain.
Thank you for subscribing.
Much.
We really appreciate it.
Thank you for your support.
It's true, we really do.
Yeah.
No,
what do you say?
You say it's true. We really do.
It's true.
You don't whisper that.
It's true. We really do.
I say it like Jack.
I don't know how Jack says it.
Just do an impression of Jack.